fans, and welcome to another episode of The Penalty Box with your host, Kalal Oakman. Tonight is a VHL exclusive. For the first time ever on this television show, we have none other than the Pittsburgh Penguins assistant GM, Hockey Gal, joining us tonight on the program, but that'll be later on. First, we got to get to the news of the day. The VHL bidding for Season 6 is currently underway. Last episode, I told you about some of the big-name players that have some high-priced tickets, and also some big names that have zero bids. I got a little flack for saying some of those names, because some organizations don't want to draw too much attention to themselves. And frankly, I got a weird message from one Devil Wears Prada, or Archenemy, or whatever his name is this week, saying that he'd really like to be on a training camp somewhere. He hopes no one bids on him, period. I don't know. If that was your problem, I don't know why you even signed up then. Strange. Going through the bidding results, some teams have been forthright and forthcoming with their information. The press releases are as follows. I'm just going to give you a summary of what I've read. There has been a lot of these teams. I'm just going to go through a couple of them here. I can't go through all of them. We don't have enough time on tonight's show. But a lot of these teams are beginning to look a little bit nasty. They have been doing their homework. A ton of scouting games. A frantic, fierce bidding competition. It's war. And it's started already. Some of these teams that have released released information about their rosters are, frankly, both shocking and head-scratching. Not in a bad way, though. Take, for example, the Calgary Flames. Now, we all remember what happened to Calgary last season. They ended up flaming out towards the end of the season, and Demers was left with a sour taste in his mouth after watching Minnesota make the playoffs with the division title that he was trying to claim. Well, let's just say he's still bitter in Calgary, and it shows. Lucky Luke Le7, last year's defenseman from the New York Islanders, who was a Norris Trophy nominee, and in some circles, some people think that he got jobbed from that trophy. Be that as it may, I'm not here to dispute or discuss that. He's just one of the names that they picked up on their roster this season. The Calgary Flames look to make huge strides in that division. So if I was you, Minnesota, Edmonton, Vancouver, or the Colorado Avalanche, I'd watch out. Speaking of the Colorado Avalanche picked up a star forward named Mish Factor. They were involved in a huge bidding war for that forward, and they look to base an offensive line based around his talents. Good luck to Mish Factor and the Colorado Avalanche. You guys are going to have some serious competition. Don't forget about the trades, too. Edmonton acquiring Ricochet from the San Jose Sharks. The division looks like it's no longer going to be known as the Redheaded Stepchild Division. That division is out for redemption. Just look at some of those teams in the division and what they have done this season in the bidding. It's unbelievable. Also, other teams that are looking extremely dangerous, and the cerebral assassin himself, the master of all disaster, the bidding maestro, Smirky, is at it again. Pulling the wool over the league's eyes, all smug and everything, picking up great talent, all-star talent, for relatively cheap prices. It's almost like he went to Walmart to pick up all-star forwards. What the hell was the league thinking? Too late now, Smirky was able to do it. More power to Smirky and his scouting team, because you guys did a hell of a job. That lineup that he posted in his press conference is, frankly, dangerous. Extremely dangerous. Last season, Smirky had his hands full with dealing with the New York Islanders, and it shows that he's preparing for another battle. He's digging in the trenches. It's going to be bloody in that Atlantic Division. Also, another team that looks to be making a huge stride this offseason, the San Jose Sharks. However, there is a little bit of controversy going around this team. Be that as it may, that lineup is still disgusting. And I'm not talking about puke disgusting that you want to go vomit. I'm talking about disgusting like, holy shit. Exactly. Chicago Blackhawks, sticking with the West. They made a nasty contribution to their team as well. You know the old saying, if you can't beat them, join them. Yeah, look at the name I'm talking about and you'll see what I'm saying. But, by far, the most shocking team so far that has released information about their team. The Ottawa Senators. A team that was a cellar dweller all of last season. Gunner, under the new owner of the Ottawa Senators, has vowed to make sure that Ottawa is both competitive and noteworthy. They are no longer going to be a pushover. He is going to make a statement, and that statement is this. You play Ottawa, you better bring your A game, because they're going to smack you in the mouth. They have veteran leadership. They have some big names on that team. Just look at that roster. Gunner, you're doing a hell of a job in the offseason. Hopefully, the pieces fall in place for you, and you develop some chemistry. It's not just about big names. You also have to have chemistry. And from the looks of it, yeah, I'd say so. Also, another big name to hit the free agent market and picked up by an arch rival, just Donnie too, picked up by the Nashville Predators under new ownership. That new ownership is out of Quebec province, or French-speaking province in Quebec, Canada. KPY, one of the GMs. That's right, Donnie has said some inflammatory things towards our French-Canadian VHL members. He has apologized profusely about that. However, KPY and management over in Nashville went out and got just Donnie. Is that a match made in heaven? Or a match made in defenseman hell? Who knows? All I know is, Donnie, you better brushing up on your French and make sure you find the French phrase for pass me the puck or I'll hit you over the head with my shovel. On to other teams worthy of note. The Tampa Bay Lightning and the Carolina Hurricanes have yet to release any information about what they are doing in the bidding session. These two teams absolutely hate each other. They are bitter rivals. Tampa Bay has been on top of that division for the last two seasons. Carolina has been down towards the bottom of the last two seasons. However, Carolina has vowed to take the fight to Tampa Bay. They have said that this season is supposed to be different. Based on the last two seasons, anything could be different. You guys were absolutely fucking trash. Sorry. I'm just saying how it is. Tampa Bay Lightning are the defending Stanley Cup champs, so obviously they are going to have to play with a big target on their back. But they have yet to release any information about the new acquisitions in Tampa. Same thing with the Carolina Hurricanes. You already knew what they had for returning members. Obviously, a Paralyzer, Drew Kidd, who they picked up in an off-season move and a waiver wire transfer, Millie, FSU Bull, otherwise known as the Bulldozer, DK Doncheri, MF Pedro, Darth Gunberg himself. They picked up new management such as Sir Sandman. Sir Sandman and Darth Forsberg, together, as management. Do I need to warn you what these two assholes did back in beta season 1? Seriously, you think some of the forum wars you have now are bad? They are nothing. They're a campfire compared to the freaking brush fire that those two started. I mean, it looked like thermonuclear war. Seriously, these guys, back in the beta seasons, hated each other. Absolutely hated each other. It boiled over from the ice and onto the forums. And then the EASHL forums. These two individuals. I mean, frankly, if you were a Vikings fan, it'd be like seeing Aaron Rodgers in a Vikings uniform. Or Herschel Walker playing for, I don't know, Green Bay, after you traded for him? It's just disgusting. It's something you don't want to see. No, excuse me. That does not even come close to what this is like. This is like Bud Grant, Hall of Fame coach, taking over the Green Bay Packers, beating you twice in the regular season, and winning the Super Bowl. That's how bad this is. And the league let it happen. Are you guys nuts? Seriously. And then, of course, there's Tudala, who's ever so smug, keeps his cards close to the chest and doesn't want to release any information. In fact, neither of these teams do. But when they do, we'll keep you covered. We'll be right back after this break. Don't go away. Welcome back. And now tonight's 2-minute miner. Mind putting it back up on the clock, please? 2 minutes. The 2-minute miner is as follows. More and more in these past bidding sessions, we've had teams become more and more shady, more controversy, more allegations, more crap flung at each other. It's just like a dirt war or something, I don't know. But it looks almost like a politician campaign where they're just flinging dirt back and forth, like a dirty message, dirty commercial, dirt this, dirt that, whatever, this team's doing this, this team's doing that. Knock it off, will ya? I mean, seriously, how hard is it to play by the rules and to what they would call the spirit of the league? It's a gentleman's league. I apologize to our female members in the league, but it is, quote, a gentleman's league. Now, if a certain player signs up for a certain position, then that player wants to play that position. If he gets bid on because he's playing that position, then let him play that position. Don't try to go underneath the table and tell the player, I want you to play a different position, I wanted you to get go for cheap. Now, if the player, by the rules, decides to change position and scouts as that particular position and is won fairly in the bidding session at a cheap price because he's not that good at that position, then that's up to the player. But don't sit here and try to play the victim card or the, oh, I didn't know who he is, and try to sneak him under the radar and make him play a different position even though he signed up for a totally different position. That's wrong. And I'm not accusing anybody. I'm just saying there's some serious allegations and accusations flying around the forums right now. Hopefully everybody's on the up and up. I'm not going to name drop. I'm not going to do that. Please, for the integrity of the league, just bid on the players based on what you know and their skill type and let that be the dictating factor in their price. And players, honor the contracts given to you. Don't sit there and tell a team, oh, I just signed up to be shady. That's bullshit. In fact, if you're found out doing that, I wouldn't be surprised if you get banned.
Ooh.
And that's your 2-minute miner. Time left on the clock, too. We'll be right back with that world-exclusive VHL First interview with the Pittsburgh Penguins assistant GM, Hockey Gal. Don't go away.
Are you willing to donate your body? Got a problem with authority? Would you stop a speeding bullet? Are you afraid of the masked man? Come on! Bring it on! Think you've got a game?
Welcome back. Now joining us via satellite from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Hockey Gal. Hockey Gal, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Hockey Gal, after 2 seasons in Columbus, one of them a Stanley Cup winning season, what brought you to the conclusion that Pittsburgh would be the right choice for you to be in management? Why not stay in Columbus?
I had a great time in Columbus. I mean, I won a Stanley Cup in my rookie season. They were a great bunch of guys, and I had a lot of fun playing with them. Originally, I wanted to be a free agent in season 6, but it changed my mind. I played club a lot with Smirk and Smart, and one night we were talking, and they decided to ask me to be their new AGM. I gave it a lot of thought, and I finally decided to take the job. Pittsburgh has always been a great organization, and I wanted to be a part of it. I decided to leave Columbus because I needed a change for personal reasons, and I felt I needed a change of scenery in the VHL as well.
Moving forward, are you looking forward to battling out in the Eastern Conference? You know, the Eastern Conference is a totally different beast compared to the West.
I'm really looking forward to playing the East this season. There are a lot of good teams in our division, such as the Islanders, and Axis team is bound to be good. I can't wait to play teams I have not played a lot in the past couple seasons. And I'm really looking forward to playing $2 and the Lightning. They better bring it, because I know we will.
Now that you will be playing in the East, you do know that you will be facing Darth Gunberg more often than you have in the past. Do you have any bitter feelings towards or about that fight between you and the stupid goon?
Well, first off, let me just set the record straight. The only reason he beat me is because he poked me in the eye. I couldn't see at all, and I still almost beat him. I don't have any bitter feelings towards Gunberg, because I know that next time we meet, I will surely win. If he doesn't, you know, cheat again.
Hockey Gale, now that you are the Pittsburgh Penguins assistant GM, are there any special goals you have set out for yourself this season?
It would be great if I could become more offensive this season, try to average at least a point a game while still playing shutdown D. I'd also like to try to win another Stanley Cup. I think we have an awesome team, and I honestly believe that we can win the Cup.
Hockey Gal, thank you for coming on the show, and best of luck to you this season.
Thank you for having me, Claw. I want to wish everyone good luck this season. I have a feeling it'll be the best season yet.
We'll be right back after this message. Don't go away. Moments in VHL history. The Pittsburgh Penguins. Only the second team from the Eastern Conference to ever make the Stanley Cup Finals. Pittsburgh Penguins, led by Smirky, defied the hockey gods by defeating the New Jersey Devils, the New York Islanders, and then the Boston Bruins, only to face the defending Stanley Cup champions, TBU the Tiny's heavily favored Red Wings. In what would become the biggest upset in VHL history, Smirky's Penguins became the first Eastern Conference team to hoist Lord Stanley's Cup. Smirky put together an all-star cast. Joining him on the Penguins that season was Empty26R, Vuvuzela, Smarts, who was his GM, Nash61, Shady AMP, Cursed Cubbies, Epcon, Scrub, the assistant GM, Upper 9 Time, Relaxation, Baga16, Treyman, Madad1369, Hot Rivet, and none other than State of United. These players, with Smirky's leadership, were able to clinch the very first Stanley Cup trophy in Pittsburgh Penguins franchise history, and also becoming the VHL's first Eastern Conference team to win Lord Stanley's Cup. It all happened Season 3 in the VHL. VHL history. Welcome back. I want to thank Hakiya for appearing on the show. We do appreciate it. It's always nice to talk to other GMs from around the league. If you're a GM or a player and you want to be on the penalty box, please send a PM to us on League Arena on the forums, leaguearena.com. For everybody here at the penalty box, to you hockey fans waiting at home in anticipation for that Season 6 puck drop, we'll see you at center ice when the puck drops. Good night. I almost forgot. Special shout out to Kylie for helping produce this video. She's the woman behind the scenes on location in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania with the interview with One Hockey Gal. So again, thank you very much for assistant producer, Kylie. Couldn't have done it without you. Good night.